When you think of what it takes to create a beautifully landscaped yard, you probably don't think of fiberglass and concrete, but these days that's often exactly what's involved.
Now this is different from most retaining wall systems I've seen. Normally it's a flat block with a lip on the back and they interlock. And here you're using pins. What are these made out of?
They're made of pultrusion fiberglass.
And why do you use a pin instead of just putting a lip on the...
Well, it's a lot stronger. It's about a 6,400 pound shear strength. A lot stronger than just a molded lip in your concrete.
So you can build taller walls?
Oh, you can build a lot taller walls. It also gives you a mechanical connection to hook your geogrid reinforcing.
Okay, and then why are there three holes in here? What's that for?
The three holes are, the middle one is a straight vertical wall, no setback. This back hole would give you an inch setback.
If we want our wall to tilt back towards the dirt.
Right, to have a batter to it. And if you wanted to protrude a course like a band or a random unit here and there.
Just occasionally one sticking out.
Yeah, just an occasional block sticking out.
We don't put them all like that, do we? We don't want the wall
leaning away from the side. Sure don't want it leaning forward. So right now we're going to build this wall on the vertical.
And then we just set these in?
That's right.
And I know they're in a lot of different shapes. This is definitely not a rectangle. Why all the different looks?
Well, it's to give it that old world look, like a rumbled cobblestone. We have three different size blocks, and what that does is give you about 12 different patterns to accent your face with.
Yeah, nice face on it. What do you do down on the corner? Does it got a face on it too?
Yeah, it also has a rumbled face down here.
That looks good. Then you just keep stacking these and keep adding pins and taking them on up?
Just stack them on up and do your gravel fill behind and your soil compaction.
And then your cap, it has a finish on the top
right,
of it as well?
Right, it has a 3-inch high cap that really sets the wall off.
And then how high can you actually stack these?
Well, with geogrid reinforcing, which is our tieback mechanism, we can engineer them up to about 30 feet high.
Now, Matt, these pins are different. They don't have a head on them. Why do you use these instead of the other type?
Well, on the other block, the pins with the cap fits in that wider track. This is a little more precise.
Those other blocks were different shapes, so you need a little give and take.
Right, that's right.
Now, these blocks look really wide. I mean, how deep are these?
They're a 12-inch thick unit.
Okay, so how high can we stack these up as a retaining wall?
As a gravity wall, up to about 3.5 feet.
Okay, what happens if you want to go higher than that?
Above that, we have a reinforced earth wall. What we do is we take a product called GeoGrid, and this will hook over the pins, and it will bury into the backfill. It's compacted into the soil behind the wall.
How often do we do this? Once we get up high, how much of this do we need?
Well, you're going to go about every 2 feet, which is 3 courses, as a rule of thumb. Worse soils, you may go more often.
So we just stake this back and then compact some soil on top of it?
You better stake it back tight and then compact that soil.
And this grid will actually hold the wall from falling over?
Right. You know, depending on the height of the wall, you'll go back further on higher walls with longer grids.
Okay. So it'd be like trying to pull a piece of rope or an old hose out of the ground.
Right, just about impossible.
Okay, it's going to be strong. And then how high can you go with this?
We have walls with the compact unit. You go about 12 feet with compacts, and above that height in a reinforced wall, you want to switch over to this standard unit.
Boy, that's big.
It's about a 21.5-inch deep unit, about a 110-pound block.
Okay.
And we have walls up to about 60 feet high with that.
That's a tall wall. I don't think we'll need any retention that high. Let's go back and talk about little walls for a minute.
Okay.
Matt, this is a retaining wall system I'm used to where it has a lip actually on the block. When do you decide to use this instead of the pin system?
Well, the lip systems are good on walls under 2 feet, flower bed edgings, tree rings, tree wells, low applications.
Anything short.
Right.
And higher than that, you go ahead and use the pin system?
That's correct.
Okay. Now, how do you decide how deep to bury the first block? Here we have a concrete pull deck, and you've dug down in the dirt a ways.
Well, as a rule of thumb, you want to bury 1.5 inches of wall per 1 foot of wall height.
So if our wall's 2 feet high, then we need to dig down 3 inches for our first row?
That's right.
Okay. And then do we need anything special below the wall to help support it at all?
We put concrete sand under this one. You could have used gravel. Mainly on these shorter walls, it's just a medium for leveling purposes so you're not rocking on the lumpy soil.
It's not really supporting that much weight.
No,
so you're not
it's
gonna
not
have to
a structural
back.
Thing, no.
Well, I like how easy it is to go together, and it looks good once you're done.
When you're building retaining walls with these larger blocks, you're going to need to excavate a trench that's about 2 feet wide. That'll give you about 1 foot for the block and another foot to add in backfill rock for drainage. Be sure to rent a vibrating compactor to pack down the earth where you dug, and then add 3 to 4 inches of crushed stone. Once the gravel is spread out evenly, you'll need to run over it with a compactor also. Follow that with about a half inch of chat for leveling, and you're ready to start stacking your blocks. If you'd like more information about engineered retaining walls, contact us on the internet at michaelholigan.com.